Welcome to our Proactive Studios. I'm Natalie Stoberman, joined by the Executive Chairman at TNR Gold, Kirill Klip. And as always, Kirill, thank you for joining me today.
Good morning, Natalie. Thank you for having us today.
My pleasure. Now, we have some more updates at the Los Azules Copper Project in Argentina, but let's recap. How have the investments by Rio Tinto and Stellantis been able to progress this project so far?
Yes, Natalie. It was a major news for all TNR Gold shareholders this year. As you know, we are building the green energy royalty metals and gold company, and we are holding NSR royalty on the entire giant Los Azules copper, gold, and silver project. And we celebrated first weeks of this year that the giant from Europe, automaker Stellantis, invested over $150 million into McEwen copper, and Rio Tinto increased their stake to $55 million. They invested $25 million last summer with Rob McEwen, and this year they invested another $30 million in Los Azules copper.
That's incredible, Kirill. And we do have some assay results that have come out from Los Azules. What are those saying?
Yes, this is the major pieces of the beautiful technical picture for this enormous, enormous copper deposit in Argentina. Results are coming in, I would say, spectacular again. Some drill holes return over 500 meters of 0.66% copper. Others return even as high as 1.4% copper over 172 meters. And as you remember previously, we discussed the deposit seems to be open to the north and south and at depth. And one drill hole returned over 1,000 meters of copper mineralization.
Incredible. And when it comes to the project as a whole, what is the potential looking like for future growth?
Yeah, this is exactly what Rob McEwen is working on with all his team at McEwen Copper and McEwen Mining. They're preparing new PEA, which we're expecting to see maybe even this quarter already. And they drilled already 25,000 meters this season. And the drill holes are showing that infill results are confirming the previously defined mineralization, and now they are testing the extension of the deposit to the north, south, and the depth. And already deposit is very, very big. Really, it's over 30 billion pounds of copper. And Rob McEwen is talking, if you convert all metals content in this deposit, like gold, copper, and silver, we can be talking about 60 million plus gold equivalent deposit.
And as the company as a whole, how is the TNR Gold being impacted by the progress happening at Los Azules when it comes to the company's valuation?
All I can say at this point, Natalie, is that we're getting a lot of calls. A lot of people in the industry are waiting for this new PEA, which will put this giant deposit really on the industry map. As you know, M&A in copper is heating up. And Rob McEwen is talking about his royalty holding on Los Azules, which could be valued as high as $100 million based on recent Asisca deal in Ecuador. And it will put our royalty valuation up to $30 million plus US dollars. And of course, our market cap is still below $10 million, so we have a lot of room to grow and hopefully bring very good news to our shareholders this year.
Sounds fabulous. Thank you for sharing this update with us, Kirill.
Thank you very much, Natalie. Have a great day.
Again, the Executive Chairman at TNR Gold, Kirill Klip.